2 3 years, I was continuing this practice. Like in beginning and all, like I was not very clear about my references actually. I thought my works are like narrative. So I was trying to make some fake narrative, not fake narrative, some
script.
Maybe I was trying to make some narrative, or I was trying to find some narrative from my work. So like some, like I couldn't get any narrative from my work. Then okay. I was struggling, like what was my work actually. And I was clear about my I was taking my reference from some resources, like maybe a popular drama like happening in my place, or maybe a backyard in my house, or maybe my surroundings. This landscape and all is all like this tropical, very local tropical landscape in my livelihood, or like my house or my surrounding. And and this posture, the poses are all this all absurd poses and all, like I was not clear at that time, like accidentally means I don't know, like I always try to draw this all absurd like posters, like maybe like a man drinking water, or like a lot of mundane activity I try to fuse with this very historical heavy, maybe to say like that kind of images, this colonial archives. So this kind of practices I started. Then I was think like, and the other thing is I use models. Like, to draw, I use models as like maybe my friends or my like who's available for me. So I use that this also. So accidentally, or I don't know, like intentionally, some like kind of hybridity came in my work. Like maybe if I draw a white character also, some kind of that localness, or like we can say a kind of hybridity is coming in character. And first it came accidentally, then I was trying to understand that hybridity, like how that hybridity is working. And then I was trying to take that kind of reference also, like how in movies and all, how the like especially in old movies you can see Amrish Puri is acting like a white man, or
understand
that kind of things, like a makeup drama thing, no makeup and all,
like a mock-up mock-up
and
thing.
Same thing that
I
was trying to study about that. So when I study the parallelly, my work is going like a similar way. That time I do parallelly the research also, but when that research reach in a area, then I started more confused about my work. Whether like should I continue the same practice, or should I just separate this landscape and this figuration out? Then I was more thinking about this body politics and all. So how landscape is going with it, and this kind of question I'm facing now. And the language also. Language means the style of.
I mean that's the thing. When like when you see the paintings or the artwork coming from, like especially Kerala, or the style which is has developed for a very long time.
Yes.
So I see that, I mean, you know, like there is a lot of. Hello, can you hear me?
I can hear.
So there is a lot of resemblance of other contemporary artists, like especially in terms of the style. But how do we, I mean, like challenge that? How do we, like, you know, like once you, I have experienced that unless and until you do it, you know, like you do it for a very long time, and then you realize what has been done and what, how to take out your own part out of this. You know, like it's very important to, like be aware of what we are doing. So I understand that you are facing this confusion and problems, but I see that it's not a, I think it's a beginning of what you want to do in the future. So your question was like, how should I that you said that you use these kind of characters in your paintings, or you create a kind of a narrative, but yeah. I want to say, like, how does this connect it to your own experiences and reading? Do you read a lot of like novels or like stories?
It's actually my this story. There is no narrative actually happening in my work. That mm-hmm. I realize. The thing is, it is not at all narration. Mm-hmm. The thing is, I am just reconsciousing the already existing documents or this archives. Like, there is a stereotype yeah. of depiction. So I'm mm-hmm. trying to reconsciousing or like baking that stereotype of depiction of native body.
Mm-hmm.
So that so later and all, I was very clear about that position. Like, I realized that my work is not narration, and mm-hmm. there is no there is no direct connection with a historical story or historical incident and all in my work. Mm-hmm. It's all about then I was trying to understand the post-colonial kind of things and all through this hybridity and all. Then I was thinking, like, I was understanding that the colonialism, what we are talking about, actually in India, it is like we have to talk about that internal colonialism.
Yeah.
It's not like somebody is like someone from outside is doing colonialism.
Yeah.
Then, like, that from that point, I thought that I'm in a correct way in this. Mm-hmm. This is about absurd act in my work, you know, mm-hmm. because I always I take reference from my this colonial archives or colonial visual representation or visual documentation. Then I'll make in my own way, actually.
Yeah, I understand. It's not just, totally. I mean, that's the thing. I mean, what possible is here is that you can, like, maybe create your own narrative. That's what I mean. Like, there is no narrative, but you maybe can, like, because there are these images here which has like a very strong existence, what we see in the, like, what we call it is like a divergence in India, mm-hmm. like in a social divergence. So what you said about, like, a colonization, or we have to look at beyond the colonization, is that, yeah, that's true. That, I mean, like, we still have those kind of situations before and after the colonization.
Yes.
So, yeah, but how do we see, or how do we represent that? That's the question. And what I like in your work is that there is a lot of human and nature existence.
Yes.
And yeah, and the way you have depicted in, such as in the sketchbooks, this is very strong images out there.
Yes.
Like, yeah. And the cutter, yeah, tell me.
No, if you are talking about a particular image, you know, can you just say the slide number so I can also check in there?
The sketches, there is one image in your portfolio. It's called the sketchbook works, watercolor on paper. And above that, there is this small cutout. I think, like, there are small painted cutouts that you did on the paper.
Yes.
So I think, like, you know, like, here the whole thing has changed. You know, you don't need to, like, paint the entire garden. You don't need to paint the entire thing. So that's quite interesting here, is that you take these small cutouts and take a photograph in different, I mean, this kind of practice can be, can lead you to somewhere. I mean, like, to make it more different. And also, try to imagine this. I'm just saying that one can also try to imagine this as a three-dimensional form, no? Like, with these cutouts, like putting them in a kind of a situation where, and everything can be, like, connected. As I see, like, then you can find a narration out of it. I mean, that you can make your own narration out of it, such as, because, you know, when narration happens, like, you know, you take an image, then you try to connect those and find a meaning with another image. Like as if here, there are three people who is like carrying a serpent, right? And there is one man above, yeah. He's trying to search something. You know, like this images creates a kind of a story, or it kind of creates a kind of a situation.
Yeah.
And then we began with this, like the concept and who is this person, or who are these people are, and why they are carrying this serpent, and how did it came to like those situation. So, you know, like this can be the possibility in your work, which I really liked it. I mean, like when I see your earlier paintings, like with the larger, like depicted garden, and also the background, I feel that one has to also see these, I mean, you have to try these in your natural or actual backgrounds, or without anything. Like the individual image has like a very strong existence.
And I made some, now I'm nowadays I'm doing this individual like depiction only, like the composition. It's like in my last paintings and all, even natural things also I'm doing like one plant, or maybe one tree, something like that I'm trying to
later maybe you can try, you know, like juxtaposing these images all together. I mean, like you can just play around with it. I mean, there are lots of possibilities. When I say the possibility, that means like you have to try with the, let's say like there is one image, but you have to try with the alternative possibilities, you know, like trying with the water, trying with the stone, trying with the different kinds of elements. Then maybe, you know, like you would come to a point like, oh, this is, and also try to find your own interest in reading or watching or whatever, like whatever you follow by heart, you just have to believe those interest and just follow them. Yeah, that's my, I mean, like that's what I really felt while looking at your portfolio. And one more thing, like you know, like you have like given an untitled to some of these works, so I was curious why do you want to call them untitled?
Actually the problem is this that tree is carrying that work. Maybe in future I'll put a title. Now it's like I have started some 3-4 works in this series. Then I'm, this is kind of what to say, like a kind of transition period, or it's a solar X for me. It is like I did this work, then I started another work. Now like the same thing is going on. Maybe once I reach somewhere, maybe that is super clear about what I'm trying to say, or what I'm trying to depict. The thing is, maybe entire series will be one name, or maybe something will come like that.
Yeah. But at the same time, I think like when you say untitled, it means like, it's like, you know, like you are not giving
non-representative.
Non-representative, something. And also like somewhere you're stopping also the viewer to get into your feeling or expression. I always very aware about like keeping the titles, and titles it makes a bridge, you know, like between the viewers and the and our artwork. So I feel even if you want to call them untitled, think about untitled's meanings, like what is untitled means, like.
And so, but can, this is the title will come. Like I think this work will be titled in future.
Okay. Super.
Because I didn't display this this work, actually I kept for my solo show. This from this work I started this this thing.
I also like these batik natural prints that you did. It's really interesting.
That I did in Piramal, actually. In Piramal, this Piramal art residency, I got a chance to do a residency in title of this thing, Indigo. So so we were doing Indigo things, and then I tried.
Yeah. No, those are very interesting. Very, very interesting. You know, like here is something that, you know, in your practice that I feel that there is a different direction that you're taking now. Like, this is interesting. Like, in this one meeting, we can like talk about everything, I'll be happy if you have like further questions or anything you want to know or ask, whatever, I'll be happy to help you in any case.
If you share your email ID or something so we can.
I will. Sure. I'll share with Amida and he will share with you. And I hope this discussion was helpful for you. If you want to ask any further question or anything, let me know.
Your points were very, very interesting. Like about this cutout idea and all. I already started this cutout idea. Even I also thinking this possibility of cutouts and all. Like a lot of people are saying about this, like there are like two kind of like people who like my work. One is like some people they find more possibilities on figuration part.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Then there are people who like they are thinking about my earlier work composition and this landscape, that area also. My issue is like I'm trying to find a possibility in that also, like this drawing this landscape also, because landscape is that also part of my concept actually. The thing is like the idea of landscape and this because landscape is for us it is landscape actually. Landscape is actually property end of the day, the real landscape. Yeah. Property, yeah. Or it's a part of it's like a ownership of land or that kind of things. This natural resources, that kind of thing. So especially in every colony, natural resources are, it's a kind of product or it's a source of income. So that possibility also I'm thinking, and I'm trying to there also this botanical drawing that we have, that history also with this colonial history.
Definitely.
So I'm finding that possibilities also in my work. Now I'm not thinking about that much because I want to solve this issue, these figures and all. Maybe in future I'll think about this part also, and maybe I'll try to, as you said before, that juxtaposition again will come once I.
Definitely. I mean, like to you just need to like combine or try different things. And combine these two interests or two different elements together once, and then see possibilities. Yeah? That's the only thing. Santosh, आपका क्या-क्या मतलब issues है या फिर मैंने देखा आपका काम तो कई सारा कुछ interesting ideas हैं आपका, but मैं जानना चाहता हूँ आप मतलब और क्या सोचते हैं आपके काम के बारे में और फिर हम लोग उसके साथ discussion कर सकते हैं. आप कहाँ पे आपको problem आ रहा है, क्या अभी सोचते हैं वो सब?
वैसे तो मैं केजे स्कूल ऑफ आर्ट से पास आउट हूँ 2000.
हाँ
अभी मैं थोड़े शॉर्ट में ही बोलूंगा, टाइम भी कम है
तो. हाँ श्योर.
तो कॉलेज टाइम में ही मास्टर से मैंने काम करना चालू किया था. हाँ वाला मार्चिस होता है.
हाँ
उससे मैंने काम करना चालू कर दिया था और काफी लोगों को भी इंटरेस्टिंग लगा, मुझे भी एक नया मीडियम मिल गया था.
अच्छा.
वही फॉर्म्स को लेके मैंने एक साल ग्रेड किया.
अच्छा.
ये भी चालू है.
हाँ.
तो बट मेरे माइंड में बहुत कंफ्यूजन ये था कि ये काम टिक नहीं पाएगा बहुत साल.
अच्छा.
बहुत सारे अलग अलग मटेरियल में भी मैंने काम चालू किया, इंस्टॉलेशंस करना या प्रोजेक्ट आते गए वैसे मैं वैसे काम भी मुझे करना पड़ा।
अच्छा राइट।
हाँ जैसे कि इंस्टॉलेशन करने का टाइम आया था तो इंस्टॉलेशन करना पड़ा, देन जैसे कि टेक्स्ट शो था, टेक्स्ट का शो था, शुभलक्ष्मी शुक्ला, तो यही था कि सिर्फ आर्टिस्ट को पेंट लिखना है, पेंट कुछ करना या कुछ भी नहीं करना है, लिखना है। एक आर्टिस्ट लिख सकते हैं, बहुत सारे आर्टिस्ट, बट मेरा में वो कभी कि मैं कभी तो फिर वो भी मेरे लिए चैलेंज था कि चलो से लिखना है। ये जो क्वेश्चन आया था तो फिर मैं एक टैगलाइन मैंने ट्रेन में ही बैठे बैठे आई मेरे दिमाग में, लिख दिया कि लिख तो मैं भी सकता हूँ। वर्ड पढ़ने वाले मिटाने वाले पढ़ नहीं रहे। तो इसमें ये था कि मैं जो कहना चाहता हूँ सुन ही नहीं रहा है, थॉट से भी वो लाइन आया होगा। सेकंड वर्क मैंने जय किया था, जय
जय
रबर से मिटा दिया आगे लिखा हुआ। तो मेरे बारे में ये काम करने के पीछे ये था कि अगर मैं जय लिखता हूँ तो अब क्या पढ़ते हैं, क्या पढ़ता है, कोई भी व्यूअर क्या पढ़ता है, सब लोग अलग अलग पढ़ते हैं। ये साइकोलॉजिकल थोड़ा काम था मेरा कि व्यूअर पढ़ता है, जैसे मैंने जय पढ़ने के बाद अगर मैं जय माता पढ़ूंगा और आप जय पढ़ने के बाद जय हनुमान पढ़ोगे तो आप, मैंने जो जय माता पढ़ के मैं बाजू में हो गया तो आप आके उसको मेंटली यूरेज करके आपने जय हनुमान पढ़ा। तो ये मुझे यही क्वेश्चन होता है कि ये सब जो ऐसे डिवाइड कैसे हो गए, ये क्वेश्चन से ही मैंने वो काम किया था।
अच्छा।
हाँ देन दूसरा काम मैं बोलना चाहता हूँ जो मुझे थोड़ा सोशल बेस है और जय के बारे में भी सोशल बेस ही काम है, देन बैलेंस के ऊपर काम किया था। एक वीडियो मैंने देखी थी कि राजस्थान में एक इंसान को जिंदा मार कर उसको जिंदा जला गया था।
अच्छा।
तो वो वीडियो अचानक से मैंने रात को 1:30-2 बजे कुछ मैंने देख लिया था और उसका असर मेरे पे इतना हुआ कि मैं डर गया था। अभी उसके बाद ही कुछ दिन बाद आउट ऑफ द बॉक्स उनके एक शो ऑर्गेनाइज हुआ था रत्नागिरी में और उसका वो क्यूरेटर का भी कंटेंट यही था कि बॉक्स को लेके कुछ करना है, बॉक्स करना, बॉक्स ऑब्जेक्ट दिखना चाहिए।
अच्छा।
तो वो उसके अंदर मैंने जो अपने डोर का आईबॉल होता है जहाँ से हम बाहर देखते हैं मैंने वो आउट ऑफ द बॉक्स में काम किया और उसके अंदर मैंने एक कुराड रखी है और फार्मर रिलेटेड कुराड है कि जो फार्मिंग के लिए गया था वो इंसान और उसको वही कुराड से मार दिया, मैंने जला दिया। वो व्यूअर के लिए अभी बॉक्स देखने के बाद व्यूअर को पता नहीं चलता कि अंदर क्या है, जब वो देखता है अंदर तो ब्लड है, देन समथिंग कुराड है, देन वो क्वेश्चन करता है कि क्या है। और दूसरे साइड को मैंने दूरबीन लगाई थी, दूरबीन के अंदर मैंने माचिस से जला हुआ एक हेड बनाया। काम किया तो टाइम आया कि मैं कंटिन्यू एक बॉडी वर्क कर नहीं पाया जैसे मैस्किक में अगर मैं काम करता तो 2000 से लेकिन 2020 तक मैं बहुत सारा काम करना चाहेगा, बट उसमें मेरी पॉसिबिलिटीज बहुत कम है कि ऐसे चीजों को मैं उस मीडियम में कैसे दिखाऊं। और देन ऐसा ही है कि इसके वजह से मुझे प्रॉब्लम है कि मैं मटेरियलिस्टिक काम करना चाहिए या नहीं करना चाहिए। मेरे पास एक्सप्रेस होने के लिए जो मैं मेरी इमेज है उसमें तो हो नहीं पा रहा, मुझे तो करना ही पड़ेगा, ऐसा भी आंसर है मेरे पास अभी। देन शुभलक्ष्मी टेक्स टू किया था, उसमें उनका कंसेप्ट यही था कि थर्ड जेंडर लोगों को लेके काम करना है, बट आर्टिस्ट ने फिर से फोटोग्राफी कर,
अच्छा
फोटोग्राफी कर आर्टिस्ट, फिर वो भी चैलेंज था मुझे कि यार मैंने तो फोटोग्राफी कभी की नहीं तो कैसे करूँ।
तो हाँ,
ये कंटेंट मेरे दिमाग में आया कि जब एक तृतीय पंथी जब साउंड करता है
तो
तुरंत अपना माइंड ये काम चालू कर रहे कि अभी ये आएगा मुझे इरिटेट करेगा पैसे मांगेगा। मुझे ये क्वेश्चन आया कि ये ताली क्यों बजाते हैं, तो फिर एक थर्ड जेंडर बहुत बड़े नाम है गौरी सावंत जी, तो उनके पास गया, उनसे बातें की, तो उन्होंने बताया यही बताया कि तुम लोगों को इस समाज को अटेंड करना, मींस अटेंड कर देना,
अटेंशन
क्रिएट करना हमारे तरफ, उन्होंने यही बोला। तो फोटोग्राफी में ये था कि पूरा तुम थर्ड जेंडर का पूरा बॉडी का फोटो लो, न्यूड लो, जो भी लेना है, ये फ्रीडम था। तो मैंने सिर्फ उनका कान का फोटो लिया, कान का। अभी कान का फोटो लेने के पीछे मैंने जो स्केचेस इसके ऊपर किए, तो थोड़ा रिसर्च करने के बाद पता चला कि मैं पैदा मेरे माँ के पेट में हुआ हूँ, तो उसके पीछे ये रीजन नहीं था कि मैं मेल पैदा होऊंगा, फीमेल पैदा होऊंगा, मैं थर्ड जेंडर में डिवाइड हूँ, नेचुरल है प्रोसेस। तो कान का जो अभी सेकेंडरी मैं उसको ऐसे देखता हूँ कि वो गर्भ में जब एक अवरक तैयार होता है वो वैसे फॉर्म मुझे दिखता है। देन सेकेंडरी वो साउंड रिलेटेड, तो उनके कान को भी एक साउंड का एक घुंघरू था, तो रिलेटेड वो मेरे ऑब्जेक्ट या मेरे थिंकिंग में जो चल रहा था वो काफी मेरे ऊपर गया। ऐसे बहुत सारे अलग अलग प्रोजेक्ट मैंने किए हैं, और
अच्छा ओके
होने की वजह से
हाँ।
और कोची बिनाले में मैंने रिलेटेड कोची लैंडस्केप किया हूँ, एक कैनवस पे के पूरे जर्नी में 2020 तक मैंने बहुत कम कैनवस पेंट किए, 3-4 हो गए बड़ा कैनवस करे अभी लॉकडाउन पीरियड में कहाँ तो ठीक है, या फिर मैं काम मुझे बहुत लोगों को अच्छा लगता है, बिक भी जाता है, रहता नहीं मेरे घर में, तो मुझे लाइफ जर्नी निकालनी चाहिए, तो सारे प्रॉब्लम्स हैं। बट मैं मैस्टिक का काम बिकता है इसलिए करूंगा, तो फिर ये जो फीलिंग्स है मेरे वो पॉसिबिलिटीज नहीं है, इसलिए मैं करना भी नहीं चाहिए।
राइट राइट, नहीं बहुत अच्छा बोला आपने कि सब चीज के बारे में, एक एक मटेरियल हो गया, कॉन्सेप्ट हो गया, और आप क्या सोचते हैं सब चीज के बारे में। और एक अच्छा हुआ कि आपने जितने वर्क्स है वो सब के बारे में भी बताया। तो जैसे अभी क्वेश्चन होता है कि आपने बोला कि मटेरियल जैसे कुछ इफीमेरियल होता है ना, तो मुझे लगता है हमें इसका प्रैक्टिकली माइंड में रखना चाहिए एज एन आर्टिस्ट। जब हम लोग मटेरियल यूज करते हैं तो मटेरियल्स का खुद का एक लाइफ होता है, हर मटेरियल का, जैसे पेपर है या मेटल है और हर चीज का, तो वो दिमाग में रखना ही चाहिए। और ऊपर से जब कोई भी मटेरियल जब हम यूज करते हैं तो उसका हम लोग डेफिनेटली पॉसिबिलिटीज देखते हैं, उसको ट्राई करते हैं अलग अलग तरह से ये सब है. बट अगर वो जम करता है, जैसे आपके प्रैक्टिस में आपने बोला कि आपके यहाँ पे अभी ये यूज करने का मन करता है, कभी वो यूज करने का मन करता है, कभी लगता है कि अगर ये रहेगा, कंजर्वेशन का जो पार्ट है वो बहुत ही चैलेंजिंग है, वो आर्टिस्ट के हाथ में नहीं रहता है कई बार. और दूसरी बात यह है कि मटेरियल्स अगर आप एक्सप्रेस होने के लिए पर्टिकुलर मटेरियल्स यूज करते हैं और वो आपको रिलेवेंट लगते हैं, सबसे पहली बात है कि आपके मटेरियल्स आपके कॉन्सेप्ट से रिलेवेंट होने मतलब चाहिए, मतलब ऐसा जरूरी नहीं कि चाहिए चाहिए, बट जहाँ तक मुझे लगता है कि इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू थिंक अबाउट दैट कॉन्शियसली. उसको उसको अगर कॉन्शियसली आप सोचते हैं कि हाँ ये जो मटेरियल कर रहा हूँ, जैसे आपने फोटोग्राफी का भी किया और जिसमें एक ईयर बना हुआ है, वो मुझे अच्छा लगा, मतलब अभी अब स्टोरी पता होने के बाद और इंटरेस्टिंग लग रहा है मुझे. और वो एक फोटोग्राफी का मीडियम है उसमें, और आपके जो पेंटिंग्स हैं और आपके जो इंस्टॉलेशन है, स्कल्पचर हैं, या फिर राइटिंग ही ले लो, राइटिंग के अलग अलग हर हर मीडियम के हर अलग अलग पॉसिबिलिटीज होती है और उनके लिमिटेशंस भी होता है, राइट? तो जैसे राइटिंग के आपके इसमें ये है, तो राइटिंग के मटेरियल्स में मुझे बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग लगा कि आप एक पोएटिक वे से सोचते हैं चीजों को, जैसे जब राइटिंग के बारे में जब सोचते हैं तो एक कहीं ना कहीं वो इंटरेस्ट वो लाइन ही इंटरेस्टिंग है कि लिख तो मैं भी सकता हूँ किंतु मिटाने वाले पढ़ भी नहीं रहे, मतलब ये ऐसा एक सीन है कि क्रिएटर मतलब एक आर्टिस्ट कुछ चीज कर रहा है या फिर क्रिएट कर रहा है और उसको कुछ देख भी नहीं रहा है, तो वो एक मे बी कंफ्यूजन आपने एक्सप्रेस करने की कोशिश की है वहाँ पे. और मटेरियल्स का और मतलब मुझे लगता है मीनिंग के साथ बहुत सारा रिलेशन है. जब आप मटेरियल्स जैसे मैचस्टिक्स यूज किया आपने, कुछ प्रीवियस वर्क है आपके जिसमें वैन गॉग का भी इमेज डाला है, तो उसका लेकिन रिलेवेंस आपको मतलब उतना ही रखना चाहिए उसका कि वो क्या है क्यों है. और मटेरियल्स आपको अगर कंफ्यूज करता है तो आपको मटेरियल को कंफ्यूज करना चाहिए, यू नो, लाइक जैसे मटेरियल्स को कंफ्यूज करना मतलब जैसे उसका आइडेंटिटी आइडेंटिटी के साथ खेलना उसके मटेरियल्स के, या फिर उसके साथ उसका कुछ ट्रांसफॉर्म कर देना. जैसे कुछ कुछ मटेरियल्स ऐसे होते हैं जो काफी स्ट्रॉन्ग होता है और कुछ कुछ मटेरियल्स होते हैं वो बहुत फ्रजाइल होते हैं, है ना? जैसे मिट्टी हो गया, अगर टेराकोटा का एग्जांपल लिया और मेटल स्कल्पचर का एग्जांपल लिया, तो दोनों एक अलग अलग मटेरियल्स हैं, बट एट द सेम टाइम दोनों का एग्जिस्टेंस और दोनों का ये टेराकोटा भी कई सालों तक रहता है बट वो फिर भी फ्रजाइल कहा जाता है, है ना? इट्स अ वेरी डिफरेंट अप्रोच व्हाट यू लाइक. जब आप सोचते हैं मटेरियल्स के बारे में तो थोड़ा डीपली और जाना चाहिए. और जैसे कुछ मिट्टी के कुछ स्कल्पचर्स होते हैं, भले इमेज कितना भी पावरफुल हो, या फिर जैसे फीस्ट बनाए या फिर और कुछ रोबस्ट ऐसा फिगर इन, जैसे अपने गणपति या फिर दुर्गा के जो मूर्तिज होते हैं, तो दिखने में वो पावरफुल भी होते हैं बट एट द सेम टाइम वो बहुत फ्रजाइल भी होते हैं. तो ये जो कॉन्सेप्ट है ना, मतलब ये जो प्ले है मटेरियल्स का, तो उसके साथ आप मतलब ट्राई कर सकते हैं अलग अलग चीजें. और बिल्कुल मुझे लगता है कि ऐसा कंफ्यूजन रखने की कोई जरूरत नहीं कि आपको ये मटेरियल्स यूज करना चाहिए या नहीं करना चाहिए, बट ये इस बारे में अवेयर रहना चाहिए कि आप वो क्यों कर रहे हैं और उसका रेलेवेंस आप कैसे लगाते हैं आपके कॉन्सेप्ट के साथ. तो बस उतना ही है. और है ना, ब्रेक करने की कोशिश कीजिए ज्यादा से ज्यादा. जैसे मैस्टिक्स का काफी एक्सप्लोरेशन करके देखा आपने, बट वो फिर भी एक लीनियर जैसा आता है, मतलब एक जितना आपका मुझे लगता है आपके अंदर बहुत सारा ये ऐसा स्ट्रॉन्ग इमोशंस है, स्ट्रॉन्ग एक्सप्रेशंस है, बट आप जब करते हैं तब वो एक सॉफ्टली करने की कोशिश करता है. जैसे वो जो सी सॉ का है, एक आपने वर्क बनाया है सी सॉ का, तो उसमें एक इमीडिएट एक्सप्रेशन दिखता है, मतलब यू नो लाइक इमीडिएट एक्सप्रेशन, जैसे कि जब से ऐसा पेड़ को काट के जब से ऐसा, इट्स टॉक अबाउट द एंटायर टाइम पीरियड ऑफ लाइक लेट्स से 10 इयर्स और 20 इयर्स. तो इस तरह से आपने विजुअल्स को अलग अलग तरह से ये किया है हर पेंटिंग्स में, स्कल्पचर में, इंस्टॉलेशन में, बट कहीं ना कहीं बाउंड भी किया है. आई मीन लाइक मटेरियल ने आपको बाउंड किया है. तो ट्राई करो कि जितना हो सकते उसको, क्योंकि क्या होता है, डिस्ट्रक्शन becomes, sometimes destruction becomes a point of creation, you know, जब आप destruct नहीं करते, आप तोड़ते नहीं, फोड़ते नहीं. मैं ये नहीं कह रहा हूँ कि आप जित काम बनाए फोड़ो, लेकिन ideas जो है ना, ideas को हमेशा हम लोग तोड़ सकते हैं, हम लोग उसके साथ लड़ सकते हैं, हम लोग उसके साथ अलग अलग तरह के experiments कर सकते हैं ideas और materials के साथ. तो वो बहुत अच्छा possibility है आपके काम में. और एक था जो ये वॉयलेंस का जो आपने बोला, जो मुझे लगता है आप बहुत सेंसिटिव पर्सन है एंड सेंसिटिव आर्टिस्ट भी. जैसे क्या होता है कि कई बार हमें ऐसी हेल्पलेस सिचुएशन मिलती है, और कोई न्यूज़ देखते हैं या फिर किसी का इंसिडेंट सुनते हैं, तो हमें लगता है कि एज एन आर्टिस्ट हमारा क्या रोल प्ले करता है इसमें, और हम क्या कर रहे हैं इसको, मतलब कैसे एक्सप्रेस कर रहे हैं. तो ये बहुत स्वाभाविक सी बात है. तो उसमें उसमें जब हम लोग उस तरह से जब एक्सप्रेशन नोट करते हैं या एक्सप्रेस करते हैं ना, तो बहुत थोड़ा सोच के भी करना चाहिए, मतलब हम लोग क्या बताना चाह रहे हैं, और वो सर्टन एक पर्टिकुलर पर्सन के बारे में है या फिर द होल सोसाइटी या फिर कम्युनिटी या लोगों के बारे में है, तो वो थोड़ा क्लियर होना चाहिए. लेकिन जैसे पीपिंग का जो आपने किया है, जो से जिसमें एक्चुअली टेक्निकल टर्म से देखा जाए तो कॉन्वेक्स और कॉनकेव ऐसा टर्म है उसमें. जैसे आप कॉन्वेक्स और कॉनकेव अगर लेंसेस लेंगे तो एक चीज पास और एक चीज दूर दिखेगी आपको, अगर दोनों के साथ प्ले करेंगे तो वो एक अच्छा इंटरेस्टिंग पॉइंट है कि आप एक बॉक्स में भी सोच रहे हो और आउट ऑफ द बॉक्स भी क्रिएट करने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं. और क्या था, हाँ आपने, हाँ एक इंटरेस्टिंग बात बताना था मुझे. जैसे आपने बोला था कि जैसे कान कोई पैदा होता है ना, तो किसी को पता नहीं होता है कि वो कौन सा जेंडर लेके पैदा हो रहा है. तो मेरे पास एक इंटरेस्टिंग बुक है जो आपको शेयर करूंगा बाद में, कि I born as an ear, ऐसा करके एक बुक है जॉनी रॉजर का, जिनके साथ मैंने पिछले साल एक कोलैबोरेशन किया था. तो वो एक इंटरेस्टिंग फैक्ट लगा मुझे कि कैसे हम जेंडर को स्पेसिफिक हो जाता है जब वो पैदा हो जाता है. जब तक वो अंदर है तो उसका कोई लाइक जजमेंट, कोई भी जजमेंटल नहीं होता है. सो एज सून एज वी गेट दैट फीलिंग, यू नो लाइक ऑफ बींग लाइक, और मैं बोलना चाह रहा हूँ कि कई बार ये ह्यूमन नेचर है जजमेंटल होना, या फिर जैसे ताली बजा के लोग पहले ही डर जाते हैं, मतलब सुन के पहले ही डर जाते हैं कि अब ये मुझे सताएगा. तो ये होल स्ट्रक्चर जो है सोसाइटी का, वो उस तरह से डिजाइन किया गया है. जैसे अब ये शुरू से चलता आ रहा है. लेकिन इंटरेस्टिंग ये है ना, मैं मे बी आपको एक बुक शेयर करूँगा, उसके बाद हम लोग इसके साथ और डिस्कशन कर सकते हैं. और क्या लिखा था सर, विजुअल इन्वॉल्वमेंट मटेरियल. हाँ, आपका भी कुछ कुछ टाइटल्स वाला का इशू है लगता है, क्योंकि कुछ कुछ चीजें आपने भी अनटाइटल करके रखी है. तो उसके बारे में थोड़ा सोचिए. और जैसे आपने पीडीएफ भी क्रिएट किया है ना, तो उसमें भी थोड़ा सा काम करना चाहिए टेक्निकली, आपका जो पोर्टफोलियो है वगैरह उसमें. हाँ, और मुझे लगता है ज्यादा से ज्यादा लोगों के साथ आपका इंटरेक्शन होता होगा, जब काम आप एक्सप्लेन करते होंगे या फिर काम दिखाते होंगे, तो मे बी मिक्स रिव्यू आते हैं कई बार. जैसे आपने बोला कि आपको कई बार कभी लगता है कोई ये बोलता है, कभी वो बोलता है, तो आपको बोलने वाले बहुत लोग रहेंगे, सजेशन देने वाले भी बहुत लोग रहेंगे, बट आपको अपने इंस्टिंक्ट पे बिलीव करना पड़ेगा. और आप क्या सोचते हैं, और स्ट्रांगली, हाँ ऐसा नहीं कि मतलब, और उसके लिए बहुत हार्ड वर्क की जरूरत है और लॉट ऑफ रीडिंग। जब आप रीडिंग, आपके काम में अगर रीडिंग का इनपुट करेंगे ना आप, तो कई सारी चीजें आपको अपने आप सॉल्व होने लगेगी। और जैसे आपका काम मतलब कई कई पुराने काम भी है, कई नए काम भी हैं, तो ऐसा एक मोमेंट आता है हमारे पास। जैसे हमने, मैंने समझो एक आर्टिस्ट ने 2010 में, आपने 2010 में काम चालू किया और एक सर्टन शिफ्ट होते गया, बट आपको पता नहीं था इन द बिगिनिंग कि आपने क्या किया था, ठीक है, और क्या कर रहे हैं। बट एक टाइम पीरियड लगता है उसके लिए, सर्टन टाइम पीरियड लगता है कि होल अंडरस्टैंडिंग रिवाइज करने के लिए, फिर उसको फिर से समझने के लिए। तो हो सके तो आप अपने लिए, खुद के लिए डिस्प्ले करके देखिए सब कुछ, कहाँ पे एरर है, कहाँ पे आपको लगता है कि ये सही नहीं हुआ था। और जो हम लोग कई बार जब आइडियाज क्रिएट करते हैं, कुछ डिस्कार्ड करते हैं और कुछ ऐसा लगता है कि ये आइडिया परफेक्ट है, तो डिस्कार्डेड आइडिया और परफेक्ट आइडिया, उनको सबको एक साथ करके एक बार आप रिवाइज कीजिए आप पूरा अपना प्रैक्टिस, तो मे बी आपको एक कंक्लूजन मिल सकता है इससे, ये प्रैक्टिस से, और मे बी आपको यहाँ से आगे और पॉसिबिलिटीज मतलब खोज सकते हैं आपके, क्योंकि आपका काम सही में मतलब वर्सटाइल, अलग अलग मीडियम से लेना देना है आपका काम का और आइडियाज का, तो आपको एक लाइक क्या बोलते हैं उसको, ऐसा फ्री होता है ना, जैसे एकदम फ्री माइंड होता है कि ये भी किया वो भी किया, ऐसा मतलब अलग अलग और इजी रह के ये करना है आपको, और थोड़ा प्लेफुलनेस आना चाहिए काम, तो फिर इंटरेस्टिंग हो सकता है वो। आई होप ये मतलब आपके लिए सही रहा मतलब ये कन्वर्सेशन।
और नहीं, मुझे और एक जानना है कि जय के बारे में आपको क्या लगा, जय के
बारे में। जय देखो मतलब मराठी में बोलते हैं ना, व्यक्ति तेवड़े वाली, म्हणजे जितने लोग होते हैं उतने लोगों के मतलब प्रकार हो सकते हैं। तो वो एक मेज जैसा है, मेज नहीं बट एक ओपन ये है, प्लेटफॉर्म हो सकता है सबके लिए, तो उसको और उसके कई पॉसिबिलिटीज है उसको, जय का अगर जय हनुमान होगा या फिर जय सागर होगा या जय कुछ भी हो सकता है, तो वो एक प्लेफुल वाला मूवमेंट है, उसमें अलग अलग तरह से लोगों को एंगेज किया जा सकता है। मतलब जैसे है ना, पहले एक जैसे टेक्स्ट बुक में एक्सरसाइज होता है, फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स होता है ना, वो ब्लैंक छोड़ देते हैं और उसमें फिर क्रिएट करो, तो कुछ का कुछ ये होते जाता है, मतलब जैसे स्टोरीज भी होती है कई सारी वैसे, तो वो एक इंटरेस्टिंग लगा मुझे जय का। बट आपको और प्रैक्टिस करना पड़ेगा उसके साथ, मतलब उसके साथ जैसे आपके वर्ड्स का अगर आपको इंटरेस्ट है, वर्ड्स के साथ खेलना या फिर कुछ जैसे होते हैं कुछ प्रोवर्ब्स होते हैं या फिर कुछ थ्योरी होता है या लाइंस होते हैं, सेंटेंसेस होते हैं, उसके साथ अगर आपको प्ले करना है तो आप कर सकते हैं, वो इंटरेस्टिंग एक्सरसाइज हो सकता है। नो, वो तो पब्लिक एंगेजमेंट ज़्यादा है उसमें, वैसे उन सब काम में, तो उसमें आप तो एक पोस्टर्स बना सकते हैं या फिर कुछ भी डिजिटली कुछ फेसबुक ऑनलाइन या कहीं पे भी कर सकते हैं, बट वो इंटरेस्टिंग है। आप इरेज करते जाओ और उसके साथ जैसे आपने कुछ सोचा बट आप एक लिंक दे रहे हैं या फिर क्या बोलते हैं, चिंगारी लगा रहे हैं और उसके बाद अपने आप चलता जा रहा है सब चीज, वैसा ही मुझे लगा। हेलो, हाय मोमिता।
हाय
हाय।
So, I actually started the work with a thread, and I worked for art, as you can see in my portfolio. Yes, and actually मैं जो काम हो रहा है अभी मैं वो इसी के साथ कंटिन्यू कर रही हूँ, लाइक टैपेस्ट्रीज, एंड देन आई थॉट कि उसको अगर मैं एक 3D शेप दे के थोड़ा फाइबर स्कल्पचर्स के जैसा 2D सरफेस इज ट्रांसफर्ड इन 3D सरफेस, सो नाउ इट्स गोइंग इन दैट पार्ट एक्चुअली। तो ऐसे ही काम को अभी प्रोग्रेस में चल रहा है, लाइक शेड्स different threads, like mota patla, different threads, knotting I'm using in my work. So it's a different, you know, dimensions, you say, like different formation also I created. So the form actually basis, I choose, you can see the circle and oval. So it's not, you know, there is a motion. It's not cutting anywhere. There is a motion of the form. That's why I choose. So, yeah, in that way, I'm just doing the work. So. I also do some drawings and also trying to interconnect with the weaving with the drawing. So it's in that way, it's actually processing. And regarding the color concept, I'm, so yeah, in that way, actually, it's processing the work.
Mm-hmm.
So, and regarding the color concept, I have a color palette of like black, gray. I also use that myrobalan color, like lots of vegetable colors, dyed threads I use in my work. So it's a nominal shade. It's very eye-catching in the work, and at the same time I use kind of vibrant color. So, you know, it can like suddenly a new color, then vibrant. So it's make a connecting in the color. So people can see from this way to this, in that way actually I work.
Yeah, I reviewed your work and I think it's very interesting, and especially I like these color combinations a lot, like the works which is so I like a lot. Before we join this call, I got some review from Vaishnavi about your work, that you have some questions about the colors, I think. Yeah.
Yes, I have questions that you can see in the work that I also made in my work to make, you know, that's I'm saying that there is like some new color shading I use with the vegetable color, and then there is some I need to use the very bright red, so it can you know, focus your eyes in a different dimensions. So that's why I use red. There is not kind of but actually the questions come to me like kind of feminism. So to clarify, if you can give any, you know, idea that there is a, not like only feminism, but there is a different way you can use.
You know, I don't see that directly, that the feminism in your work. I mean, of course, I mean, when it comes to this kind of practice, you know, like especially the weaving and knitting, there is already there is the things a lot to think or connect to the feminism directly. But when I see your work, that I don't feel, I mean, I feel that you are quite enjoying this kind of, you know, like making this kind of forms, and also.
Yes, I involve myself all.
Yeah. One can see that in your work, that how much the involvement, and also this, you know, there is something in your work that, I mean, like, where you're maybe struggling with the form or with this the colors, and trying to create something new out of it. You know, like this medium has long history, as you know, that there's lots of things to do with the thread, and there's lots of things to do with the society, and even how the knitting was even practiced in India and also in abroad. Like, you know, like there is a lot of things to do with this. But at the same time, you know, like there is how do we see that in your current you know like life or contemporary life? So I remember from my home itself that my sister used to create certain kind of like designs or decorate the home and decorate our interior inside our house. So there is something that is that that creates that movement, that creates a lot of things. There is the involvement of other people. There is the involvement of the community, because you know, like once you see those kind of activities, you automatically attract other people, because it is related to a lot of meditation and also a lot of patience, because to do this kind of creation is not very easy. So what I mean to say, what I mean here is that maybe you have to like cross these boundaries, what you are doing right now. I mean, like it's completely amazing what you have done. As I see in these pictures, like from 2019, there is this work called Social Formation, which has this kind of like form, and it has this different kinds of form popping out of that main thing.
Yes.
So I really like that. And also about your drawings, I mean, like your drawings are very different than the than these visuals, and it has this endless possibilities in your work. I don't know, I mean, how much I would be able to tell you or like guide you in this, but I think that these three-dimensional images, the three-dimensional sculpture that you are creating, this might lead you to like a different kind of language. But at the same time, you have to be, you know, like if somebody asks you or tell you to about the color, but you have to, and if you tried those, if you try using colors your work, and tried making these kind of forms, but you have to see how much you are comfortable with this kind of with using this kind of colors, and you should question why you are using this color, and how do I use colors in, and how do I want to use a color? I mean, let's say because the color, when we use the color, it has meanings. If we go into that point, if you think about it, so it creates sometimes, you know, let's say like that with the example of like I would give example of the Turkish flag here, because they say that there was a war that was happening in the Turkey, and the entire country was so blooded and red that they could see the moon in the blood as the reflection. So that's how this whole map of the Turkey has depicted as a red and with this star and the moon, half moon. So, you know, like there is this meaning that, and it's a deep meaning, it's a very deep meaning that I don't know why this country has this kind of flag. You know, it creates this kind of question. So what I mean is here that when you use certain colors or certain forms, you have to think about it, why you are using it, and try using, like, you know, there are in your work there are multiple colors, and there are certain points where you stop using different colors. So it's a mixture of like maybe you try to like merge them, or maybe you try to like give a different kind of the forms, and also the thread, because I am not very familiar with the making of these works, because I see that there is a like thinner thread, and also there is a very thick thread here. So of course, this kind of, when you use this kind of like threads, it becomes it appears very differently, I mean, like visually. So and I see that there is
make different textures.
Yeah exactly. And I see there is a lot of things that to connect to the, I don't want to say that abstraction, but at the same, I don't want to create that point here. But what I mean is here is that, like when I see that particular image here, it is called evacuated. That almost feels like the center of the parts almost feel like a sunset or something like that. So it's up to the, you know, like when you think about certain kind of forms, you have to be precise at what you want to create.
Which word are you saying?
This is word called evacuated in thread. This is just below the wounded form.
Okay, evacuated one.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Yes. And there is also one thing that you have used some words like a society or a beauty. I mean, how did that happen?
The last time in 2019 when I was in Piramal residency, so that time I was experimenting with different kind of work, not like a tapestry. So I made a fiber sculpture and then that sprouted society, the big one.
Yeah, yeah.
And then I created a small, very small work. And then I was thinking that time actually we are writing a lot about our concept note and our CV. We're just making a way that how to why not we change our to develop our concept note, because lots of people were talking every day. Mm-hmm. So that time I thought that we're writing, if I make the writing in a kind of make a writing in a word. So that's why I picked one word and then started to weaving. And I thought that after completion of the work, I like that word. So I thought that why not it's become a work. And then after coming home, I had interview with CWIT in 2020. So I thought that I should have make this works more so I can show in my interview. So that's why I make that beauty and then wall. So wall is I make in that way that in our society there is a wall between one people, between two of the people. It's wall not like that. It's a wall that we are saying that there is a wall because you are not seeing me. We are not connected to each other. There is a wall. So that's why I make the wall thing and then I started to paint. And there are, started creating some formations are there. So it's coming from dissolve the wall and create another formation. So that's the same with beauty.
Okay. Why I ask? Because I felt that when you say society or when you say like a beauty, especially society, there is a direct representation of the society, or people might want to interact with as with their understanding is like this is kind of a society that we are living or weaving. But at the same time, I feel like, as you said, that the beauty one, I think there is a lot to do with this weaving. And how do you, there's also like that some kind of material that you're using here, like the metal wire.
Yes.
And metal creating pop. This kind. Yeah. And also creating this, the form. I think that there is this, the possibilities at the same time, do you feel stuck somewhere here? Or do you feel that, that you want to explore this medium in a different way, or do you feel that the representation of this work should be different?
Yes, because since I started, so I am thinking about it to starting in a new way. So in a new dimension, how can I create that work? So it's actually going on in my mind, and then that's why I am preparing some sketches and all every day. So yes, it's going on.
Okay. I might send you some references and some readings for you, and like, you know, like how other artists, because we have to see how other artists have used these kind of materials in their work. It is not necessary that you have to see, but it's important. It's important see how it has been used, and also like the tapestry and also the visual forms. How do they connect with their visual ideas and concepts? You know, there is one interesting tapestry that made by William Kentridge, where he involved a lot of people, like mainly the woman who has, there is a, it's like a community work, but with the singing, you know, like with the singing, they're singing and knitting, singing and knitting. And they are actually telling the stories of what their life is suffering from. And that was really interesting. I will send you that reference. And also there is one reference I found. This is nothing to do with the, like tapestry, but the weaving. There are women in Burma who actually started weaving while they were crying, because they were crying because they were husband and their children have been killed by the police, by the paramilitary. And they were crying and crying and crying, and they started weaving. One woman started weaving the shawl. Like in Burma, they have like this red and black shawls, and they use like very specific materials. I mean, it's very specific colors. And that, maybe this example might help you. So they were weaving these kind of stories and these kind of songs while they were weaving. So one woman started. So like the next day, the other woman also started, because they also have lost. So it became a chain after end. And there were around nine specific shawls, which becomes very important for that time period. You know, like, and this is how I feel that how we document our memories, or we document our time. So there was a specific formation to depict the military, to depict the people, like their people. You might see that kind of simplification of form in Egyptian art, or any art which has like simplified human bodies. So it was depicted like that. And also, like, there are some formations which has meanings, you know, like certain forms has meaning. So what I'm trying to tell you is that maybe you should like look at these kind of practices, what has been done or what has been created, and what could be done by your side. I mean, like, what is the most important thing that you feel need to be tell, or need to be expressed, or need to be documented? So if you think in that way, maybe you would come to a point like, oh, I really like this kind of form. I mean, like, what is that? But it has, you know, there are some things like in our society or in our generation that we lose our, you know, like belongings. We lose our belongings many times, but we don't understand that at that time. But we have, like, when the moment passed, or when the time passed, we realize that, oh, we lost this. I mean I'm talking about our day-to-day objects. I'm talking about the memories that which as in a child or as in a young person, when we were in that time, we lost those kind of elements in our society. So maybe it can be the game, it can be the object that you used to like in your childhood. So it can be anything that you like right now. So if you like look at this kind of maybe, like, if you find your interest are going towards like maybe reading or writing or whatever, I'm just trying to tell you that try to find something which is completely untold, or which is coming from, I'm sure that your most of the thoughts or most of the, like, the forms that you have created has a meaning and has a lot of thing to do with you and also your surroundings, but at the same time, try to break them now. Try to break them and try to re-caution them with your own understanding. And with the color, I'm sure that it has to be specific now. It has to be very different.
Yeah. Can you tell me the name, William?
William, I will write it down and I'll send you the links.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll share everything with Amita, then he can share with you. Or maybe we should exchange, like we should write a group email so we everybody can know.
I
hope this was helpful, no?
Yes. And one more thing I need to ask you that I have a question that as an artist, how do you think to process further?
Like process further.
Process further means we are practicing artists. So how do you think that in that way, you know, artists can move to in a further way to the other areas, like for exhibitions, for...
How do you continue your practice, right?
Yes.
Acha. Okay, you know, like this is very...
If I go to the galleries or if anybody like our in our age as a, you know, young artist or as a practicing artist, so how do you think that they can be, you know, talk or they can approach themselves like me? How do you think that,
You know, most of the things happens sometime by the time, and also like the artist has to also work for it, you know, like it is, nothing is given free here. So we have to really work hard for that. And how do we do it is that we have to meet people actually. Like there's a lot of artists who feels that their practice is not so important, or their practice is not, you know, like there is this always in mind. Even I was like that. I used to feel that I don't know anything, I can't do it, I won't be able to survive in this field. But you know, like the most important thing in our in my case is that I really had a good friends. I really had a really good artist friends, and I feel that artist has to unite at some point, and artist has to be linked what is going on and what is happening around them. And to survival is the very crucial question for the artists and also for everyone. So I think like applying or exhibiting to different places or different exhibitions or residencies, that is one option that artists can do, is that applying for funding, applying for like residencies. And the second thing is that you need, like when you apply for certain things, that sometimes you might not heard from these residencies, or but they do follow. I have seen people that following my work for 5-6 years, but never talked to me or never approached to me. But it was important, but I was not aware about that, if they are watching or not. But it was important that they are following. So we have to be up to date. Like, you know, it's not back in time that the artists used to think that, I don't care and all of that. But it doesn't really work in this time period right now, because we have to be very prompt and responsive to what is happening, and an approach to people. There is nothing wrong. There is totally nothing wrong to going to the people and asking for, you know, review, just a review. I'm like, we have to become a friend. And there are galleries, I'm sure there are galleries like which might not like talk to you or might not give an attention to you. That will happen. But what I'm saying is that, as I said, like the collective practices or the artist together can change things. So we, as if now, let's say Shriju, he is in Baroda, right?
Now from 1 year I am not in Baroda, I am in Kochi, my hometown.
Acha. Okay.
Yeah, but I was in Baroda for some year.
Okay, so what I'm saying is that here that we have to make our platforms, you know, like we have to engage each other and support each other, and that's the only way I think that that can way to go further, you know. Like there are a lot of people we met in our journey that and they were our friends, just friends, and after that, after years, they invited us to certain exhibitions, certain residencies, and that's how things happen. And if you talk about like commercial in the commercial point of view, I really feel very difficult even to go into that way. But mostly I would suggest that to try or create your own platform, you know, like that's most important. And there are a lot of things that are happening right now online. So I'm saying that there's a lot of things that right now are happening online, and a lot of things that is happening in alternative spaces. So alternative spaces and collective spaces are becoming more popular in India now. So, and that is what the breaking the whole structure. I mean, like one has to also think about defunctioning the center. So what I mean is that defunctioning is like, let's say like the art hubs are like Delhi, Bombay, or like any other city. So we have to defunction them. We have to like think about how can we create a kind of a platform where everybody can be visible or equally given like a equally given importance to their practices. So with my own experience, what I will tell you my own experience. So when I moved to Baroda, I finished my study and then I came to Bombay. That time I did not really have any view or understanding of what I'm going to do, but I assisted Tushar so for a year, and after that, like I met few artists in Bombay. I was very new in Bombay and I did not have any friend. So, but the Clark House initiative, it was started in 2009 and I joined it in 2011. And we used to literally create an exhibition. We were like volunteers out there. We were like exhibitors, or we used to create exhibitions especially for the Clark House. And that practice actually turned our understanding about the exhibition making and what is exhibition means and what is art creating means and what is political understanding of an artist and how it needs to be responsible. You know, like there were a lot of questions at that time. So with that platform, we reached to like many, many people, you know, like in the Bombay, there wasn't, it wasn't easy, like, you know, to go to the gallery and like, you know, like, hey, hello, hi. It wasn't like that because we were also like learning. So in the beginning, it was very hard. But slowly, like it was, you know, sometimes you just give somebody like now you have to talk about it and you talk about others' practices. So, and slowly that platform has given us a lot of things. After that, the gallery started approaching us. It wasn't us that went to the gallery, but the gallery find our practices that unique and also different. And that's how it became, like it started actually. And after that, so residencies can help you a lot to study and read and explore your practices, but that might not help you to survive, you know, like, because in the residency, you don't get like that much funding to survive, but you have to try, you have to push yourself hard to reach to this kind of platform here where you can sustain. And it's very important for an artist to reach to this kind of platforms like galleries or alternative places or wherever.
Okay. So do you think that like my works it's completed like straight kind of works? So I heard that lots of people told me that this kind of work more appreciated in abroad rather than in
mm-hmm.
need to talk with about that. But do you when you connected with a lot of galleries, so do you have any idea that how galleries think about this kind of works, like my work?
I really can't answer this question. I mean, it's very maybe hard for me to like answer this because I am not a gallery and I don't really talk to the galleries.
I meet with like when I was in when I got INLA scholarship INLA award, mm-hmm. that time I meet with Jasha Kola and
Jasha Kola, of course. Husband. Yeah, huh, huh.
Yes.
Yeah, Luca.
And then lots of people. Yes, and then I also met lots of people like that. There is a residency in Pune, and then. In what about that residence? But they told me that this kind of work is much appreciated in abroad. So, do you send any pictures and all? And I said, no, I didn't have that much of connections to send. But yeah, it's like that.
Yeah. Many times, you know, like appreciation happens in a different level. You know, like. Appreciation happens on the understanding actually and giving importance to those kind of practices. That's what the appreciation happens because in India still we are all struggling to understand whole art practices and like different kind of practices.
Yes.
I don't know like mine whether it is abroad or it is our mentality or our understanding that we are incapable to understand because I don't think that we don't have these kind of practices in India. Of course, we have these kind of practices in India and it's really rich. I mean, like we have a history of this. So don't think so much about these things. I mean, of course, it will happen gradually. But as I said, like you have to try hard and you have to reach to the people. If you know anything that is related to your practice or related people might be interested in this, of course you should send your work to them. And sometimes it is important artists to travel rather than their artwork to travel. You know, like it was very important. So why I'm saying is because when we travel, we gain a lot of different experiences and we gain a lot of understanding. Like traveling abroad and traveling in India as well. We change a lot. Our thought, it is like the feeding to our thought process, the traveling. And try to use the material it is there and try to use and create a different kinds of language. It might take time to understand what is happening with us. But it's a great process that I have experienced. And also like one more thing, which I said to materiality, to Santosh, sometimes it's okay to like let it go. You know, like there are moments, there are works that cannot survive. But you have to understand and experience that as well. Because there has lots of works, especially I can give you my own example again. That I have seen lots of my works have been destroyed. And that really made me think about, you know, like the existence of the work. Because from 2012 to 2018, most of my work for this 6 years of time period, most of my work has been destroyed. They don't exist. But those ideas and the visuals, they exist only with the visual and digital form. So, you know, at this point, I had to think, I had to question myself, what is that I want to experience in future? And that's why the whole thing changed. I mean, in 2018, I saw Ansel Kiefer's work in Milan, in Hangar Bicocca, in one of his permanent exhibition. I was really shocked that some kind of this huge work can exist. I mean, and then I mostly started thinking about, because, you know, like by the time your life changes and you can't move and you can't travel every time. So in this kind of situations, artist has to think, you know, like your possibilities. And because by the time we gain a lot of skills, and that moment is very important for an artist to let it go. And because there is nothing that artist cannot do. I mean, like the main human cannot do. So I feel that it is important sometimes to destroy your work. I mean, like in terms of the creating a new. When you destroy something, and then you can create new. So, sorry, I don't know why I started talking about this, but your question was something related to.
I got answer.
Okay. Super.
I got answer. I am asking you how to process, but you gave the answers. Thank you.
Okay. Great. Any more questions or any?